Excellent. Welcome back. So obviously we've got some media in the room. We got a couple on Zoom. So we'll start on the room and then Zoom. Kelly, go ahead. Start us off.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
And how are you feeling physically? How did the summer go?
I'm doing well. I did a lot of stuff to get my body right again because I was dealing with some issues at the end of the season. So I just wanted to make sure that's right. And we made really good progress combining that with working out basketball wise. So I'm in a good way.
How long did it take you to start feeling good again? Because I know it April, May, June was ankle, Achilles, back. It just seemed like you could never quite get all healthy.
Yeah, it took some time to get it fully out. And even now, sometimes it gets triggered a little bit, but we really found a way to make progress and working out and everything. So I'm fine. I can jump. I can run again like I want to. So that's the most important part.
You said it's the Achilles that you're still working on?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Brad Timmons, Dallas Morning News. Before those things happened, you had COVID. And I guess, there's still unknowns out there as to what COVID, the long-term effects could be. Mm-hmm. Do you think in any way getting COVID led to any of the physical ailments?
I'm not a doctor or scientist on that stuff, so I don't really know. I guess it could be possible that it has some side effects on your body. I would say it was a difficult season for everybody, and a lot of people of us had COVID, and dealing with all that, then having a short period of time to get back to on court, it's just tough on the body, especially if you have to follow up with 30 or 40 games or whatever. But I think this way is a complete different setup again, and we can work to get in good shape and start the season right.
Hey, Maxi, Mark Paulo, Mavs TV broadcast. Good to see you as always. This question, of course, is coming. We haven't had a chance to talk to you, and obviously it's been a lot of stability in the head coaching position here for your entire duration here. Now there's been a change. Can you share with us what your interactions have been like with your kid and what your relationship's like, what your expectation of that aspect of things is going to be this year?
Yeah, so I think the decision was made when I was in Germany. When I got here, I had actually good timing because JK was there too. So we had the chance to immediately meet up and talk a little bit. So far, obviously, the conversations are good. We're going to get into all the basketball details the next couple of days. And it's been good. I think everybody on this team is excited, looking forward to it. It's going to be a bigger change than just players, obviously, if you have a new coaching staff. But that's going to bring new ideas, new energy. And I think everybody has to kind of adapt and learn. And it's going to be exciting for everybody the next couple of days.
Dwayne Price, Mavs.com. Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Long time. I know a lot of players went through COVID and injuries and things like that last year. Just your thoughts on Dwight seems to be coming into this season, training camp, and all that.
You said Dwight?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm obviously Dwight is one of my good buddies. I'm very happy for him. I think he took this summer very serious. As far as I know, he worked out a lot and did a lot of things. So, he's got his old energy back. A player like him, he lives off that energy. He got his jumping ability too. He worked on the shot and everything. So I'm really just happy for anybody who's back healthy, because at the end of the day, you play basketball and we all compete. We compete within the team, but we also play together. We compete against other people. And the main thing, the most important thing is that everybody's healthy, because that's the best way to get the highest competition out there. I'm super happy about it. I guess we all seen what he has done in the last years for the Mavericks. He's just coming in, bringing a lot of energy and making all the shots. He's a tough guy to guard. And when you have a guy like him on the court, it's just making the job easier for everybody else, because he's such a threat. And also, playing with Timmy is fun. Because he's a type of person that takes every challenge very serious. So he wants to win badly. And, guys like that really help, because they get the best out of you every day.
Cool. Let's hop to Zoom real quick and then we'll get you on your way. Yep. Kevin, go ahead.
Kevin Gray, 105 through the fan. Maxi, good to see you once again. Going back to the end of this past year, what did you and your team learn about yourselves taking the Clippers to 7 games that you can take with you going into this season? not only with the continuity, but having another year together to grow and get better as a team?
I mean, I think we all know how good we can be, you know, if we just like focus on the things that we have to do. And that's like all the little things, the details on the court. I think there was 2 years in a row now, and last year we should have advanced and we didn't take advantage of that opportunity. So that won't happen again. We learned from our mistakes, and I think there were a lot of things that we didn't do well. That's why we lost at the end of the day. But it always helps when you have like a big core of the team together that knows how to play together. And I think everybody who's on the team or has been on the team and is new here, put in a lot of work this offseason too, to bring something new to the table and to help the team out.
Luke
ask you, Mavs Moneyball. Hey, Maxie, hope all is well. So your kind of defensive role the last couple of years has been to be the primary stopper for opposing wings. Do you anticipate some of that pressure kind of being taken off of your shoulders to guard the Kawhi Leonards of the world now that, you know, Reggie Bullock is here and Frank Ntilikina for that fact as well?
Like I said, like we're going to talk about basketball and the details like the upcoming days. I think my main role, or like what I take a lot of pride in, is still defense. So, you know, whatever the scheme, the system, whatever it might be, I still want to take that very seriously and defend. And obviously we have like with Dodo and Reggie, we have some faster guys that are able to like defend on the perimeter. And, you know, we have a lot of tall people and people that have good basketball IQ on defense to help out on the backside. So I think we will see what it's going to be at the end of the day, but I take a lot of pride in the defense. And so I just want to like keep working with the same mentality.
And Lauren, go ahead.
Hey, Maxie, Lauren Gunn, Mavs Moneyball. You recently took a trip down to Austin with some of the guys. Can you talk about that trip, the personalities and culture of this team, and any of the interactions that you've had with some of the newer faces around the locker room?
Yeah. So we spontaneously decided to take a trip to Austin, and it was pretty amazing. I gotta say, I love Austin. It's been a fun time. Like the kayaking and everything we did was just like super fun, and it was just like a different environment and getting out a little bit, so I really enjoyed that. Otherwise the chemistry with the team is really good so far. I mean, it's always like that, I would say, in the beginning of the season, but you know, we have a lot of great guys and we kept a lot of great guys from the past years. So I'm just looking forward to do all that, to have team dinners and like get a better bond as a team.
Also, quick follow-up question. Have you been able to face off Jalen Brunson on the golf course yet?
It's been a while, but I don't know if I want to play golf with him too, because every time, like, you know, he tees off and he says like, that one didn't count because it was the water. So he tees off another one and that counts as the first shot. So it's hard to compete with that.
Maxie, thank you for your time.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Did you go to 6th Street, Maxie?
Say what?
Did you go to 6th Street?
Yeah, we went to 6th Street, Rainy Street.